this is basically what you get when you use these DFM tools and the design process. You will get first pass success and first to market your products. You will get high yield, which translates to lower cost per chip. And also your design will be quality designs that are insensitive to process variation, temperature variations, and changes in the supply voltage. So overall, you will have a tremendous amount of saving in both time and money. It's very much worth including this design process in your design flow. So to illustrate for you, here are two sets of real designs. We put them on the wafer. AMP1, which uses standard design techniques. But AMP2 used the DFM design techniques. It utilized the DOE, design of experiments, and yield sensitivity histograms in ADS. Same thing with the up converter mixer, up converter 1 macro cell. It used the standard design techniques without DFM, whereas up converter 2 used DFM design techniques with the use of DOE and yield sensitivity histograms. Now remember, all these designs were fabricated at the same time and on the same wafer, and they both went through the same design process and the design process variation. Okay, let's see the results. So looking at the right plot, this is the results that we got. Notice the consistency in the output and the narrow variability, which makes the whole design robust and insensitive to the external variations, even to temperature, voltage supply, bond wires, package effects. All these will have less effect on this design because it was designed using the design for manufacturing tools in ADS. The other design, the standard design, which did not go through any DFM design methodology, look at the output, how sensitive it is and how widespread. This is the up conversion gain at 20 GHz at K-band at the output. This one is solid, rock solid. It's not sensitive, and look at the consistency of the wafer probed results. And this is the results of the amplifiers. The amplifier on the left was the one that used the standard design technique, no design of experiment, no yield sensitivity histograms, no DFM techniques. Whereas the one on the right, it went through the DFM process using the design of experiments and yield sensitivity histogram. Again, look at the gain consistency and how consistent and tight the response is. Whereas the standard design has wide variation. Also, the foundry mentioned to us at that time that during the process, the foundry process shifted a little bit to lower frequency, shifted a little bit to the left. Notice that this design shifted way to the left because of its sensitivity. Whereas this design, which was designed right at the middle at 8 GHz, shifted a little bit to the left. So again, the sensitivity is much lower in this design that have used the DFM design technique. In ADS, we have a tool. It is called the impedance matching tool. In ADS, automatically will give you matching networks. Like, look at in this example here, I got 19 different matching networks to match to, and this is one of them. And once you get this matching network, you can statistically analyze it to tell you if this matching network is sensitive or not sensitive. So by going through the 19 networks automatically, really fast, one after the other, the statistical tool in this matching tool will be able to tell you if your matching network is sensitive or not. So it allows you automatically to choose a really robust matching network that will result in low sensitivity and high yield. And this is very, very valuable tool to use in the design process. And by the way, the matching tool also has a transformation tool in it that will take your lumped elements here and transform it into a distributed microstrip lines for your MMIC circuits with the right dielectric constants and height of substrate and all these other parameters. So here's our design. We used the matching network tool. We transformed our design from being sensitive with low yield into high yield and less sensitive. This is the input matching network. This is the FET with its stability resistor and structure. And this is the output matching network. Okay? These are the tools that I have used, the yield sensitivity histograms, which tells us which sensitive component, which component is causing the problem in the design. It pinpoints exactly where the problem is. Design of experiments also pinpoints and tells you which matching network in your design is causing yield problem, so you can take it and replace it with a different matching network. And design centering and yield optimization also at the last step will increase your yield and centers your design. By the way, I want to mention that we have a full hands-on workshop lab, easy to use lab on this simple LNA, just to expose you to the tools and have you understand fully how to use these tools with ease. So we have a full example and a full hands-on workshop if you're interested to go through it. These are the results that I showed before. This is the before. Before we used DFM, you can see the yield was 22.6%. And look at the wide variation in gain, in noise figure, and in S22. After we used the DFM tools methodology, notice the gain variation is much tighter. Notice the noise figure variation at the input is much tighter, and the S22. And now we have 100% yield, and our amplifier is rock solid, and it's not sensitive to external effects like temperature, voltage changes, and bond wire and package effects. It's really worth the effort to go through this step always before you go to the physical design and finish your design. Now, power amplifier verification to wireless standards plays an important role in the MMIC design flow. And in the design flow here, just before going to the physical design, it shows that you go through that step to verify your power amplifier to wireless specs. And this is how it is done. ADS wireless verification solution uses both realistic input signals and test benches for all wireless standards that are 100% compliant with the wireless standards, such as WIMAX, UWB, and LTE, and others. The process is fully automated and very easy to use. Simply, all you have to do is insert your power amplifier in this template or test bench and hit simulate. The solution will help you not only test and verify your designs, but will also get the best circuit performance. It allows you to shoot for the best performance in your design by also ensuring that you meet the wireless specs. It offers speed increases of up to 100 times over traditional methods, you know, this verification. And I will show you an example in the next slide or two. So here's an example of verifying for EVM specs on a WiMAX PA. I designed a power amplifier. I inserted it right here in this test bench for WiMAX uplink transmitter EVM measurement. Once I put my amp right here, all I have to do after setting the power level, you know, where you want to measure the EVM, at what input power you set it, all you have to do is just hit simulate, and the results will come automatically.